Okay, fund flow statement. Okay, we'll start now. Here in the cash flow statement, we have taken all the items in the balance sheet, and we have calculated totally what is cash at the end of the period, and that should be matched in the balance sheet also. Then only we have calculated the right one. Then here in the fund flow statement, we need to calculate only the working capital changes. Okay, that's all. Only working capital changes, that's all. So after that, we will make after calculating the working capital, then we'll do the items where this fund has come and where the fund is going out. Means nothing but sources and applications of the fund. Okay, this is the basic one. And here the term fund flow statement means, according to the Smith and Brown, fund flow statement is prepared to indicate in summary form, that is changes occurring in the items of financial between two different balance sheets, such as statement is prepared to indicate the increase and utilization of resources of business during an accounting period. Okay. So this fund flow statement is nothing but where got, where gone statement, or a statement of funds generated and expended. Okay. And the famous name is statement of sources and application of funds. This is fund flow statement, the meaning and definition I have given. Then the meaning of fund is, what is the meaning of fund is? The fund is the, basically that is the net working capital, that's all. Means what all happening in the net working capital, that is known as fund. Here net working capital formula is current assets minus current liabilities. So fund flow statement, the fund represents the net working capital. So with this only we are going to calculate. Okay, then you need to know what all items in the current assets and current liabilities. I will brief you once with a few items. In current assets, we'll come to know that cash and bank balance, then inventories or stock, and then another one is accounts receivables, then is accrued incomes, then marketable securities, and also we have investments. Okay, then in the current liabilities, we know that main is bills receivable, bills payable, then outstanding expenses, bank overdraft, income received in advance, provision for tax and proposed dividend, then provision for doubtful debts, and another one is creditors. Okay, these are the few items I have mentioned in current liabilities. Then you need to know about what are non-current assets and then current assets. Assets which are realized after 1 year, that is known as non-current assets. Means like plant and machinery, land, building, all these things, etc. Then the non-current liabilities, and here you are knowing all these things in basics only, but how this flow of fund will occurs and what is flow of fund. So flow of fund occurs whenever there is a transaction between the fund. Okay, what is the fund is the source of fund and also the application of fund. Where the fund is coming from and where this fund is getting utilized. If both these are there, then there it will occur the flow of fund. And how to judge whether the transaction it is flow of fund or not? We know that what is flow of fund, and we have to judge whether this is flow of fund or not. So in the cash flow statement, I have already explained to you that current assets and current items and non-current items. If the transaction involves current and non-current, then only there will be an flow of fund occurs. That's all. Okay, if there is a current and current transaction, then there will be no transaction at all, no flow of fund. Sorry. Okay, example I will tell you that no flow of fund is bills receivable realized. When bills receivable is realized, so here when you write down the journal entries, we will write what cash account bills receivable realized means. We are getting cash. Cash account debtor to bills receivable account. Here, cash is also an current asset and bills receivable is also an current asset. So both the items are current in nature. So there will be no flow of fund. Okay. Then again, one more example I will tell you. Yeah, purchase on cash or credit basis. That is purchase account debtor to cash or creditor's account. The purchase account is in current in nature and cash is obviously a current in nature. So both the items are current in nature. So that's why there will be no flow of fund. Okay. Then in the several examples also there, while we are doing the problems, we will solve that one. And here, after knowing all these terms and also the concept, how the flow of fund occurs and how to judge whether this transaction results in flow of fund or not, and also the items which are involved in this flow of fund and the meaning of flow of fund, then we'll know what are the changes and what are the calculation we are going to do is, first here the fund flow occurs only in working capital, that's all, because the fund is termed as nothing but net working capital. So in net working capital, the formula is current assets minus current liabilities. So we have to calculate a statement of changes in working capital. Here is the format, please write down this format, and here is the current assets and current liabilities. Here 2 year balance sheets are given, previous year and current year. Then we need to calculate how much it is increasing and how much it is decreasing. Okay, and in the end we'll write down increase or decrease in working capital. Okay, after this we have to calculate the profit and loss account. Then we have to calculate what is the fund flow statement, sources of fund and application of fund. Okay, just write down this format, because while solving the problems tomorrow, it will be helpful for you. Or just write down this particular previous year, current year and increase and decrease, that's all. And current assets, you know what are the current assets, and then you know that what are current liabilities. And in the last, you just write down increase or decrease in working capital. And while calculating this statement of changes in working capital, there is a thumb rule, and also the adjusted profit and loss account also. I will show you the thumb rule. You just write down this thumb rule. Just write down this thumb rule. I will explain you what are things happening here. Here the thumb rule says that an increase in current asset, increase in working capital. So if there is increase in the current asset, when you are comparing two balance sheets, if the amount is increasing, then the working capital also increase. And decrease in current asset, decrease in working capital. Okay. And the next one is if the the next one is increase in current liability, decreases in working capital. You know that current liability, if it is increasing, the working capital will decrease. Just write down that formula. Net working capital is equals to current assets minus current liabilities. If negative sign goes on increasing, then the working capital will come down or reduce. It will okay, then an increase in current liability, decrease in working capital, and a decrease in current liability, increase in working capital. Then this is the current assets and current liability items. Decrease once again I will tell you, decrease in current liability increases the working capital. If the current liabilities is it is decreasing, then current assets normally it will increase. If current assets is increasing, obviously working capital will also increase. And then an increase in non-current asset, decrease in working capital. If there is a non-current asset is increasing, then how this working capital is decreasing? Suppose you take down that if we are purchasing the machinery, okay? When we are purchasing machinery, we are purchasing by giving cash. So cash is going out. It means current asset is decreasing. So when current asset is decreasing, obviously the working capital will go down. The working capital will decrease. So in this way, you have to understand an increase in non-current assets, decrease in working capital. Okay, and decrease in non-current asset increases in working capital. Suppose think that that land only what you are purchased, that you are going to sell it off. When you are selling, you will get the cash. Then the current assets is increasing. Meanwhile, if the current assets is increasing, obviously the working capital also increases. Okay, and an increase in the seventh point is increase in non-current liability increases in working capital. So how this non-current liability, if it is increases, the working capital increases. Suppose non-current liabilities is equities, and share. I will take one example, that is shareholders. If we issue equity shares, then what we are getting is we are getting the cash, and what is going out is equity shares are going out. That is allotted to the shareholders. So we are getting the cash. When we are getting the cash, the current assets cash, it comes in current asset. So current assets is increasing. Okay, so if current assets is increasing, obviously the working capital also increases. So in this way, increase in non-current liability increases in working capital. Okay, then decrease in non-current liability decreases in working capital. This is the 8th thumb rule you should never forget while calculating the fund flow statement. Okay, then you write down the statement of changes in working capital. This you have already written. Then after that, you write down this adjusted profit and loss account. You just write down this format while solving the problems. You'll come to know what all items we are dealing with. Here first we have to write the two non-cash fund items. then we have to write down the appropriation of profit, and in the right hand side we have to write down non-operating income. The same thing what you are calculating in the cash flow statement, here also you have to calculate, but in a different manner. That's all. There we have calculated after working operating profit before working capital changes, we have calculated the current assets and current liabilities, add or less. Increases in current assets, decreases in current liabilities, that you need to less. And decrease in current assets and increases in current liabilities, we have to add. The same thing we are going to do here in the statement of changes in working capital. Okay. Then here in the adjusted profit and loss account, same what we are doing in the that cash from operating activities, we are using non-cash items first, and non-cash items and non-operating items. The same thing we have to do here is non-cash items, depreciation, loss on sale of asset. Same thing what are given in the cash flow statement, same thing we have to write down here. Goodwill written off, preliminary expenses written off, discount on issue of shares and debenture, and premium on redemption of a debenture or preference shares. Okay. And in the non-operating items, we are writing interest received, dividend received or dividend paid, dividend received, and refund of tax, and profit on sale of fixed assets. Okay. Same items, but the scenario here is different from the cash flow, but calculation part is same, and the items which were used in the cash flow, same thing we are using here in the fund flow also. And appropriation of profit here, general reserve, proposed dividend, interim dividend, taxation. Okay. Then last thing, that is fund flow statement. This is the last item you have to calculate, sources of fund and here application of fund. After calculating the statement of changes in working capital, that amount you need to take to the adjusted profit and loss account. After getting the adjusted profit and loss account, here you see that fund from operation, the amount you will get after while calculating the adjusted profit and loss account, this fund from operation will go to sources of here. Sources of fund from operating profit. Okay. And here application, what all financing and investing activities are done in the cash flow statement, the same thing you have to do here in the fund flow statement. Last one, this issue of share capital, it comes in cash from financing activities, and issue of non-current sale of non-current asset, that comes in investing activities, and issue of debenture, loan from institution, same like that of cash flow statement. And your applications of fund, applications of fund means where we have utilizing the fund. We are utilizing in redemption of the preferences and debentures, repayment of the loan, purchase of current non-current assets, payment of dividend, taxes, and loss from operations. Okay, you write down this format. But here in the fund flow statement, the main thing is you should know how to write the ledgers. Okay, the same thing which we have calculated in the cash flow statement, while calculating the depreciation and while calculating the tax provision for tax, we have done and we have made ledger entries there. The same thing you have to do in this fund flow statement also. Okay, nothing difficult in this. Nothing is difficult in this chapter, but the thing is you need to have patience and also concentration. With these two things, you can easily calculate the fund from fund flow statement. Okay, theory part for this unit is over, and from tomorrow onwards we will solve the problems. Okay, any doubts you have? Yeah, you can take the screenshot or else you write down. It's up to you. Okay, just carefully write down this adjusted profit and loss account, or take the screenshot of this. So non-cash or fund items, depreciation, loss on sale of fixed assets. And premium on redemption of debenture or preference shares. Then discount on issue of shares and debentures. Goodwill return off, preliminary expenses return off. Then comes to appropriation of profit, general reserve, debenture sinking fund, proposed dividend, interim dividend, taxation. Okay, and in the right hand side, by net profit, non-operating income, non-operating incomes are interest received, dividend received, refund of tax, profit on sale of fixed asset. And after calculating all these things, the difference or balancing amount is known as fund from operation. Okay. Yeah, I will show you. This one is the first one. First, you have to calculate this. First, you have to calculate statement of changes in working capital. I will give you 10 seconds to take a screenshot of this one. Take the screenshot of this one. Okay. And then after calculating statement of changes in working capital, we will get increase or decrease in the working capital. Okay. Then in the second, we are calculating adjusted profit and loss account. Okay. Take the screenshot of this one also. Okay, I'm moving to the last one. That is fund flow statement. Here I have not mentioned the heading. You write down fund flow statement. Here is the source of fund, application of fund. Just take the screenshot of this one also. Okay. Theory part for this unit is done.
Are you interested in teaching? Then you have a golden opportunity to take. Join BStudy Maths Teachers Committee and get a chance to teach on an online platform and fulfill your dreams of becoming a successful teacher. For more, just fill the below form.